Who said it first? The Bible or science? Which is more accurate? Well, let's take a look at history to answer that question. First, I wanted to explain for the people that don't know about it, about the timeline of human history, that the numbers started out really large, and then they, as time progressed, the numbers got smaller and smaller and smaller to the year zero. And then the numbers started getting larger and larger and larger as we know it today. Every year, the number is a larger number. So I just want to give you that little background. BCE stands for Before Our Common Era. So when we're talking about a large number BCE, it means it was a long time ago. So the example that I wanted to mention today about who said it first, the Bible or science, I have three examples, actually. The first one is the Bible said that the earth is suspended upon nothing. Back in the day, a long time ago, people actually thought that the earth was held up by like elephants and turtles. And they had all kinds of bizarre ways that they imagined how the earth was being held, or that it was sitting on top of these animals. And there's other theories out there as well. But the Bible, in the year around the year 1473, the book of Job was written by Moses. And at Job 26:7, it says the earth is suspended upon nothing. And it was more than 3,000 years later that scientists such as Isaac Newton actually realized, I think the earth is suspended upon nothing. So the Bible had it first, 3,000 years before Isaac Newton realized it. And another example is, as we know, Christopher Columbus's day. They used to think that the earth was flat. For a long time, they thought the earth was flat. And yet, in 732 BCE, so a lot closer to us than the first example of 1473 BCE. So 732 BCE, the prophet Isaiah wrote at Isaiah 40:22 that the earth is a circle or sphere. And it wasn't until about 200 years later that the Greek philosopher Pythagoras may have proposed that the earth is indeed a sphere. And as, again, I mentioned, the Christopher Columbus in that time period, which was, 1492, if I recall correctly from that song, is when he realized that the earth is indeed not flat. But again, the Bible had it way back in 732 BCE written that the earth is a sphere. For a circle. And then the last example is about our water cycle. Let's see here. Job, so back to the book Moses wrote way back in 1473 BCE. Moses wrote at Job 36:27. He draws up the drops of water. They condense into rain from his mist. Then the clouds pour it down. They shower down upon mankind. He just explained the water cycle. And it wasn't until the 1800s that scientists actually understood how the water cycle worked. So who said it first? Well, in each of these examples, the Bible said it first, a long time prior to science catching up to it. Hope you guys enjoyed this, and like and subscribe and share if you found it helpful. Thank you. Have a great day.